In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
We are gathered here to celebrate the 22nd Sunday in ordinary time. Brothers and sisters, our gospel reading this weekend invites us to take up our own cross and follow him. In fact, following Jesus demands a little sacrifice, the willingness to suffer. Suffering is an integral part of our earthly life, but it is also our road to glory. We ask God to bless us and strengthen us to continue following Jesus. Let us then pause for a moment and call to mind our moments of failures. Lord Jesus, you raise us to new life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you forgive us our sins. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you feed us with your body and blood. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for a great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. God of might, giver of every good gift, put into our hearts the love of your name, so that by deepening our sense of reverence, you may nurture in us what is good, and by your watchful care, keep safe what you have nurtured. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. The reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. O Lord, you have enticed me, and I was enticed. You have overpowered me, and have prevailed. I have become a laughingstock all day long. Everyone mocks me. For whenever I speak, I must cry out. I must shout violence and destruction. For the word of the Lord has become for me a reproach and a derision all day long. If I say, I will not mention him or speak any more in his name, then within me there is something like a burning fire shut up in my bones. I am weary with holding it in, and I cannot. the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. My soul thirsts for you, O Lord, my God. My soul thirsts for you, O Lord, my God. O God, you are my God, I seek you. My soul thirsts for you. My flesh faints for you. As in a dry and weary land where there is no water. My soul thirsts for you, O Lord, my God. So I have looked upon you in the sanctuary, beholding your power and glory, because your steadfast love is better than life. My lips will praise you. My soul thirsts for you, O Lord my God. So I will bless you as long as I live. I will lift up my hands and call on your name. My soul is satisfied as with a rich feast, and my mouth praises you with joyful lips. My soul thirsts for you, O Lord my God. For you have been my help, and in the shadow of your wings I sing for joy. My soul clings to you. Your right hand upholds me. My soul thirsts for you, O Lord my God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. I appeal to you, brothers and sisters, by the mercies of God, to present your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to God, which is your spiritual worship. Do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your minds, so that you may discern what is the will of God, what is good and acceptable and perfect. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia.
May the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ enlighten the eyes of our heart, that we might know the hope to which we are called.
Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus began to show his disciples that he must go to Jerusalem and undergo great suffering at the hands of the elders and chief priests and scribes, and be killed, and on third day be raised. And Peter took Jesus aside and began to rebuke him, saying, God forbid it. Lord, this must never happen to you. But he turned and said to Peter, get behind me, Satan. You are a stumbling block to me, for you are thinking not as God does, but as humans do. Then Jesus told his disciples, If anyone wants to become my follower, let him deny himself and take up his cross and follow me. For whoever wants to save their life will lose it, and whoever loses their life for my sake will find it. For what will it profit anyone gain the whole world but forfeit their life? Or what will anyone give in return for their life? For the Son of Man is to come with his angels in the glory of his Father, and then he will repay each according to their work. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. In the 1980s, the government of Polish Prime Minister Jaruzelski had ordered crucifixes to be removed from classroom walls, just as they had been banned in factories, hospitals, and other public institutions. The ban stirred waves of anger and resentment all across Poland. Ultimately, the government relented, insisting that the law remains on the books, but agreeing not to press for renewal of the crucifixes, particularly in the classrooms. But one zealous communist school administrator decided that the law was the law. So one evening he had seven large crucifixes removed from lecture halls where they had hung since the school was founded in the 1920s. Days later, a group of parents entered the school and hung more crosses. The administrator promptly had these taken down as well. The next day, 2/3 of the school's 600 students protested and were forced into the streets by armed riot police. And then they marched, crucifixes held high, to a nearby church where they were joined by 2,500 other students from nearby schools for a morning of prayer for support of the ban. Soldiers surrounded the church, but the picture from inside of students holding crosses high above their hands flashed all around the world. So did the priest who delivered the message to the worshiping congregation that morning. There is no Poland without a cross. Sisters and brothers, Just as the priest said that there is no Poland without the cross, our Lord Jesus says in today's Gospel, there is no Christianity without the cross. And there is no human life without the cross. The cross is the symbol of our faith. And the cross is a symbol of our human suffering. The Gospel of Christ is a coin with two sides, the cross and the crown. If we try to embrace one side, the glorious side, and reject the other, the suffering side, we falsify the Gospel. And like the coin analogy, the cross for us today can be seen from two vantage points. On the one hand, as Christians, we view the cross as a symbol of our burdens. When we pray the stations of the cross and reflect on the death of Jesus, we develop a deep appreciation of this understanding of the symbolism of the cross. Think of how heavy the wooden cross must have been and how cumbersome it was for Jesus to carry. He fell several times. He grew weak and he needed help along the way. Our daily struggles are much the same. Whenever we hear people describing a troubling situation or something difficult that they are facing, we often hear them conclude with a statement, "But that's my cross to bear." In this way, we understand the cross to mean something we must endure. And there is often an acceptance of it. Whether it is failing health, a difficult relationship, or any number of real life issues, the cross is a symbol of the weight of our earthly burdens that we cannot get away from. We have no choice but to bear that cross. Being a follower of Jesus is much the same. It can feel very heavy and burdensome at times. It is not easy bearing the weight of our faith. It certainly was not easy for the Polish religious community. But we do our best, struggling to lift it up each day, even when we don't have the strength. Like Jeremiah, in our first reading, we too can be the laughing stock and be mocked for our beliefs. We definitely meet resistance and are reluctant at times. But on the other hand, the cross gives us a sense of purpose. When Jesus invites us to take up our daily cross and follow him, the image that comes to mind now is of picking up our cross and joining and journeying forward with Jesus, with hope and with faith. The cross can become something tangible that we can hold on to. When we do stumble carrying it and moving forward as Peter did in today's Gospel, let us remember that in being Christ's followers, there will be sacrifice and there will be suffering. But if we can hold on and endure the weight of our daily crosses, then we will experience the promised eternal life. So, sisters and brothers, let us pray for courage. Let us pray for patience. And let us pray for endurance. Amen.
Let us now profess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day He rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. We shall now place our prayers of petitions to our Heavenly Father.
Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all Christians, that we may respond to the Lord's call to take up our cross and follow Him, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who work publicly and privately to end unjust structures that oppress the marginalized, the poor, and the vulnerable, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all children during this time of COVID-19, that they may feel the love and security of their families, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those of our parish who are ill, especially Giselle Mate, and for those who care for and nurture them, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially Francesca Roca and Catherine Morden. And we pray for all who are grieving the loss of a loved one, that they may find comfort in the promise of the resurrection. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the prayer intentions deep within our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Lord, our Almighty God, in mercy and in kindness, we have offered our personal prayers before You. Answer them through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are You, Lord God of all creation. For Your goodness You have received the bread we offer You. Fruit of the earth, work of Your human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are You, Lord God of all creation. For through Your goodness we have received the wine we offer You. Fruit of the vine, work of Your human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands
for the praise and glory of his name,
for our good and the good of all his holy church.
May this sacred offering, O Lord, confer on us always the blessing of salvation, that what it celebrates in mystery, it may accomplish in power, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For through his paschal mystery, he accomplished the marvelous deed by which he has freed us from the yoke of sin and death, summoning us to the glory of being now called a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people for your own possession, to proclaim everywhere your mighty works. For you have called us out of darkness into your own wonderful light. And so, with the angels and archangels, with the thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Gerard our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glory for you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
through him and with him and in him. O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Renewed by this bread from the heavenly table, we beseech you, Lord, that being the food of charity, it may confirm our hearts and stir us to serve you in our neighbor, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.